हरे कृष्णा, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू. इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो आई वॉज डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द महादशा कैलकुलेशन, बैलेंस एंड द पीरियड. ओके, दिस टाइम आई एम गोइंग टू इलस्ट्रेट एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अंतरदशा, हाउ टू कैलकुलेट अ पर्टिकुलर अंतरदशा इन दैट महादशा और मेजर लॉर्ड पीरियड. आई विल टेक द सेम एग्जाम्पल एंड इलस्ट्रेट इट. सो इन दैट एग्जाम्पल वी हैड मून इन कैंसर साइन 22 डिग्री 14 मिनट्स एंड using the second method, this is the second method illustration. The first method I already told you, we can directly subtract the value of moon degrees from 13 degree 20 minutes, whatever balance is left converting into minutes. Then in 800 minutes, whatever is the portion covered by Mahadasha Lord is, for example in this case Mercury is 17 years. So in 800 minutes Mercury covered 17 years. So in suppose 300 minutes, how many Mercury will cover? That will give the balance. Okay, now this is the method 2. From here also, using the tables in the Ephemeris, we got this value. Subtracting the proportionate parts, always remember to subtract, never to add. Okay, because of this rule, the rule of inversely proportional. Then coming to the Antardasha, Mahadasha balance was 9 years 10 months and 24 days for the native. Mahadasha Mercury must be having the Mercury as the minor period, as the first period. Second minor period would be Mercury Ketu. Third minor period would be Mercury Venus. Because I already mentioned, and all of you also know that these dashas are in sequence. And their antardashas are also in sequence. It never starts from the beginning. It is like a cumulative dasha. Okay? So Mercury period will have Mercury Antardasha, then Mercury Ketu Antardasha. All the Antardashas will be of these planets in this order. Then after coming to last Antardasha will be Mercury Saturn. Mercury Saturn will be the last Antardasha. After that Mahadasha of Ketu will start. And when Mahadasha of Ketu will start, who will be the first Antardasha Lord? Ketu. Second will be Venus. And last Antardasha Lord in the Ketu Mahadasha will be Mercury, right? So here are already we know 9 years was the balance. That means how much Mercury dasha is over has to be calculated. How much is over is out of 17 years, 9 years and this is over. So 7 year, 1 month, 6 days is over in Mercury major period till birth. Okay, it means we have to calculate all those antardasha lords till 7 years, 1 month, 6 days, or nearby to this value. But 7 years, we should definitely come around 7 years. Okay? Around 7 years, what all the Antardasha lords were there who were over. Because 7 year is the over period, like over, which has already been covered. So who were the Antardasha lords which have already been covered? Okay? So coming to the table again, page 116-117. You turn the page. Because this table was for major periods. After that you will find the table for sub periods and inter periods. That is the sub periods. Okay. So for the Mercury, the first Antardasha Lord will be Mercury. Now how many months Mercury has given to its Antardasha Lord Mercury? This is for the Sun table, then Moon table. Come to the Mercury table. Mercury table is in page 122. Now Mercury inter periods. In Mercury. Mercury Ketu, these are the Antardasha periods. So Mercury has given total, you can see the total below. Mercury has given 28 months on the top is written, 27 days to Mercury itself as its Antardasha Lord. Then Mercury has given Ketu how many, what duration? 11 months, 27 days. Okay. Then Mercury has given Venus 34 months. Okay. Now, according to my general understanding, or maybe we can say common sense all, so I have to arrive around this period because this is the over period. I have to find which all lords are over, which is the current lord. So I got this value after adding all the values till Sun. Mercury has given Sun 10 months, 6 days, right? 10 months, 6 days. I added all of the values and I got 85 months, 0 days. I converted into year, months and days. 7 years, 0 month, 28 days. Now, matching these two values, the exact time period over and the time period still left to be covered. 0 months, 28 days. That means till Sanantar Dasha, 7 years, 0 month, 28 days were over. Still there is something remaining because here we see 1 month, 6 days. Here we see 0 month, 28 days. So we will calculate still how much has been already covered by Mercury's Antardasha Lord. Right? Now after Sun we know Antardasha will be of Moon. Okay, so we got it. Here is the Antardasha Lord. Moon is our Antardasha Lord. Okay? Because still after Sun, some days were still left, some months were still left to be covered. Which were over. So this duration was 8 days. So Moon Antardasha period was running during his birth and 8 days were already over. Out of moons, Mercury has given Moon how much? Mercury has given 17 months to Moon as Antardasha Lord. 17 months have been given by Mercury and out of that 8 months have already been covered. Okay, so Moon's Antardasha is going on at birth with 8 days over. Now remaining Moon Dasha, that is Antardasha. Remaining moons, Antardasha is, Mercury has given Moon 17 months, 0 days. Subtract 8 days because 8 days were over. Subtract and you will get 16 months, 22 days. So out of Mercury, Moon, whatever period Mercury has given to Moon, which is 17 months, these many days Moon was already covered. Moon already covered. Okay, before the birth of this person, Moon already covered 8 days. So this much is yet to be covered by Moon. We just have to add this value to the major period Lord. Okay, the major period Lord Dasha during his birth. Now here I have written the date of birth. We have to add it here. It is a cumulative Dasha system. So we have to add the periods. Now Mercury balance Dasha we found was 9 years, 10 months, 24 days. Okay, you write it below the date of birth, add it. This is the time when Mercury Mahadasha period will be over. And Mercury period will be over on 20th Feb 2001. On his date of birth, add the balance of Moon's Antardasha. Moon Antardasha balance we calculated, which is 16 months and 22 days. Add it, you will get 18-8-1992. That means on 18 August 1992, Moon Antardasha of Mercury will be over. So after Moon, which Antardasha you will get? Mars. So Mars Antardasha. Now Mercury has given Mars how much? 11 months, 27 days. For Mars, 11 months, 27 days. Add it. This is the Mars Antardasha in Mercury. So Mercury Mars will be over on 15th August 1993. Mercury Mars will be over. Keep on adding the Antardasha Lords like that. Okay. That's all from my side. I hope you practice for these. And keep on practicing. Thank you so much. Signing off for the next video. Hare Krishna.